Since the initial announcement of the Xbox Series X, Microsoft has been quite outspoken about the power of their robust new hardware. In fact, there have been Microsoft-dedicated video updates featuring in-depth hardware analysis on the Series X, also supporting the notion that this hardware would essentially be the most powerful console on the planet. In addition, after lead hardware designer Mark Cerny gave his hardware capability analysis on the PlayStation 5's horsepower, despite the wealth of detail focused on the PS5 system architecture and its efficiency benefits for developers, all anyone seemed to care about was the 10.28 teraflops of the PS5 in comparison to the 12 teraflops of the Series X, as the end-all be-all, I might add. Yet, there are many moving parts associated with the hardware, which gives way to the lasting results of our interactive experiences. Before we go any further, please be sure to hit the like button, as it truly helps out the video. And if you're new to the channel, please be sure to subscribe and also hit the bell notification icon as well, so as soon as a new video goes live, you will certainly be notified. All right, thank you so much. Let's jump right in. And so, as it seems today in practice, Sony's PlayStation 5 hardware has continued to outpace and or match the performance output of the Xbox Series X. With the launch of the PS5 and the Series X, Digital Foundry has continued their comparable software analysis on today's most sought-after multi-platform games, as well as exclusive titles, and their comparative results have not looked so great for the most powerful console on the planet. As many of you already know, based on the specs, the Series X is pushing a higher yield of processing power over the PS5 with a 12 teraflop capable GPU and with more memory, I might add. However, despite the less compute units offered on the PS5, these units are clocking in at a higher yield on Sony's hardware, thus allowing for the PS5 to execute longer and more stable gaming experiences with multi-platform games. For starters, Ubisoft's latest and quite ambitious Assassin's Creed Valhalla flat out runs better on the PS5, and it's noticeable. Now don't get me wrong, despite the glaring shortcomings pointed out by Digital Foundry within their in-depth analysis, the game plays amazingly well on the Series X. If, however, you have nothing to judge it against, namely the PS5 version of the same game. From maintained stability issues of consistently running at a butter-smooth 60 frames per second, to screen tearing, as well as how the cutscenes on the PS5 offer more accurate and natural colors, if there was a fully optimized way to play Assassin's Creed Valhalla on consoles, the clear winner at the moment would be the PlayStation 5. While for the majority of your time with Assassin's Creed Valhalla will support an almost identical image quality across both the PS5 and Series X versions of the game, this is not the case with Codemasters' latest racer, Dirt 5. Digital Foundry's breakdown comparison reveals surprising results in favor of the PS5. Looking at each of the game's playable modes, image quality mode yields a higher on average resolution with superior texture filtering as well on the PS5. In performance mode, which offers up to 120 frames per second of gameplay, the game's graphical details are yielded higher as well on the PS5, while also dropping below the 120 frames per second target more often on the Series X. This difference in performance has been addressed by developer Codemasters and said to be in the works of being ironed out. But what about Devil May Cry 5 Special Edition? Does this game also need a Series X patch? Well, thankfully, the so-called most powerful console in the world does have a slight edge on its PS5 counterpart when it comes to performing in 4K resolution, as well as ray tracing. However, when it comes to pushing the hardware, interestingly enough, the PS5 on the game's high frame rate mode is able to run the game much better. In fact, Digital Foundry discovered that the PS5 version of the game actually runs more than 40 frames per second higher in some gameplay sequences over the Series X. And to add more emphasis on the ray tracing contrast, according to Digital Foundry's, the ray tracing between both consoles is not significant, meaning, based on the system's specs, the PS5 is pushing way above its weight. These same results are also found when comparing Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, where the Series X has the slight advantage with ray tracing while maintaining 60 frames per second, with the PS5 showing frame rate dips around 40 with ray tracing on as well. However, the Series X once again falls behind the PS5 when the hardware is pushed to output the game at 120 frames per second. Does this mean that the PS5 version of the game is the better version? Well, in the case of Cold War and even Devil May Cry 5 the Special Edition, not necessarily. I would personally call these games a wash in the contrast department, based on Digital Foundry's side-by-side showcase of the two games. But clearly, what we are seeing does not match the pre-launch hype talk surrounding the power argument. Now, let's address the excuses as to why the PS5 is either outperforming the Series X or running in stride with it. Apparently, for starters, the Series X could be suffering from development complications, such as bugs, maybe, or more or less efficient development processes. But what does that all mean? Well, there are notable concerns now that Microsoft only allowed developers to submit games for Xbox Series X certifications in June, after delivering an update to its GDK, or Game Development Kits, which followed Microsoft's tight schedule for dev kit allocations. Now, on the PS5 side of the equation, dev kits, or I should say, developers had access to the PS5 dev kits far in advance of the PS5 versions. Does that matter? Maybe it does. We find this most interesting, that prior to the launch of the Series X and the PS5, these current concerns, patch concerns, bug concerns, never made headlines that we could potentially see the PS5 punching above its weight when comparing multi-platform games to the Series X due to these development shortcomings. In fact, Codemasters had an insightful take on the Series X hardware long before they ever received the hardware. Codemasters technical director, David Springgate, states, "We started doing the groundwork for the Series X development long before we even received the hardware. This kind of thinking from Xbox allowed us to get a real head start on next-gen development. So after receiving our early Xbox Series X hardware, we were up and running really quickly." Nevertheless, the Series X performance yields in comparison to the impressive showing of the PS5 does give one pause based on the Series X hardware specs. We are, however, expecting to see patch updates for games such as Assassin's Creed Valhalla and Dirt 5. When will this all happen is anyone's guess. And when it does, are we expecting the games to run equivalent to the PS5 version or better? A Microsoft spokesperson in a statement speaking with The Verge stated, "We are aware of the performance issues in a handful of optimized titles on the Xbox Series X and S, and are actively working with our partners to identify and resolve the issues to ensure an optimal experience. As we begin a new console generation, our partners are just now scratching the surface of what next-gen consoles can do, and minor bug fixes are expected as they learn how to take full advantage of our new platform. We are eager to continue working with developers to further explore the capabilities of the Xbox Series X and S in the future." What makes this statement profound is that, like the Xbox Series X, the PS5 developing partners are also just now scratching the surface of what Sony's new hardware can do, as they are expected to also learn how to take full advantage of Sony's new hardware. And there you have it.